Even though humans have lived in the frozen north for thousands of years, we're still learning about the Arctic. Unlike Antarctica, you can actually walk up into the Arctic Circle in some parts of the world, like Scandinavia and North America, making it far more accessible. But what Arctic mysteries are we still trying to solve? This is Unveiled, and today we're taking a closer look at a bizarre discovery found in the Arctic Circle.
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
Back in 2018, NASA researchers were flying over the Beaufort Sea off the coast of Alaska and Canada. The flight was part of Operation Ice Bridge, an ongoing mission to monitor how much polar ice is left each year in both the Arctic and Antarctica. But this time when they ran the mission, scientists were baffled by what they saw. And remember, these are experienced researchers working for NASA, one of the most prestigious science organizations in the world. They found three strange circular formations in the ice, the likes of which none of them had seen before in the Beaufort Sea. When the images of these structures were released, they came with statements about how unusual the icy features were, and how researchers weren't sure what had caused them. The most obvious explanation, and the one that is likely true, is that the holes were made by seals. Seals are incredible creatures, deadly predators within their marine environments, surviving and even thriving in the chilly waters of the poles. The most abundant seal in the Arctic is the ringed seal, which is thankfully not yet threatened by hunting or climate change. Ringed seals can hold their breath for extraordinarily long times, up to 45 minutes. This is a lot longer than some other species. Leopard seals, for instance, those dangerous Antarctic predators, can only hold their breath for 15 minutes. Still impressive, but not on the same level as the ringed seal. But ringed seals do something else that other seal species don't as well. They break through thin ice sheets with their clawed flippers to create breathing holes. It's then thought that the strange circles NASA spotted might be seal breathing holes, which are actually very familiar to people living in the Arctic or studying it. But what's strange is that this particular region of sea ice had never had seal holes in it before, which led to an unpleasant conclusion, that the ice here was much thinner than it should be, enabling the seals to break through where they previously couldn't. This is almost certainly because Arctic waters are getting warmer, which gets worse the more the ice melts. Though again, a small silver lining is that seal species don't appear to be suffering because of it. While they are adapted for very cold water, they can live adequately in warmer places. For example, down in the southern hemisphere, one leopard seal named Ofa is a local celebrity around New Zealand, having inexplicably left Antarctica to live there instead. But back to the north, and around the Arctic ice holes, you'll see some further strange markings. Again, though, they can be explained. They're thought to simply be from the ringed seals splashing as they rise through the holes to catch their breaths. But this isn't the only possibility. Other things, like the movement of the ice as different ice sheets collide, could also cause strange things to appear. And what's more, geology may be to blame. Because the seas are heating up and this particular area is quite shallow, some NASA researchers blamed warm springs bursting through the ice sheet. No seals needed. But the fact is, we still don't have a definite explanation for what the strange circles are, and we might never have seen them at all if not for Operation Ice Bridge conducting regular surveys. What do you think is going on here? Seal impact, shifting landscapes, or something else? It isn't the first time that bizarre geological features have been found in the Arctic either. Unusual rock circles were spotted in the region way back in 2003, with photographs showing dozens of well-formed shapes in the ground. But what made them? Surely a series of perfect circles can't be the result of natural processes. But actually, they are the result of natural processes, with the precise patterns appearing because the ground has frozen and thawed time and time again for tens of thousands of years. It's fascinating how we, humankind, can see things like this and assume that they may have been made by an intelligent mind, perhaps even that they're messages left by ancient humans that have survived for thousands of years. But in many cases, these bizarre sightings were actually made by Earth's own geology. Similar occurrences have been found all over the world, from the Arctic to Australia and Kenya, all part of a phenomenon called patterned ground, and all created by various mechanisms. Patterns like these have even been noted on the surface of Mars. More broadly, we often see geological features that we want to ascribe meaning to. This is just something that humans apparently do. For example, yet another interesting land feature is the Giant's Causeway in Northern Ireland, a coastal region full of hexagonal basalt columns. In myth, it's said that the causeway was really built by a giant who wanted to cross the sea to reach Scotland, where there was a rival giant that he wanted to fight. But unusual as the columns appear to be, they're also, again, completely natural, created via volcanic activity thousands of years ago. Of course, that's not to say that there aren't ancient structures out there that were built by humans, and in the Arctic Circle as well. Indigenous people have lived in the Arctic for thousands of years, and further back, other human species like Neanderthals and Denisovans also lived in cold areas like Siberia. Scientists and explorers have found mummies and remains to prove it. Furthermore, during antiquity, the ancient Greeks and Romans were said to be aware of a civilization much, much further north than the Mediterranean Sea. The name they gave to this potential society was Thule, although even today, scholars aren't sure exactly where Thule was. It may have been on the Shetland Islands north of the United Kingdom, or it could have been spread across islands that today belong to Norway or Estonia. And yet, it is believed that some ancient explorers, like Pytheas of Massalia, may have successfully crossed into the Arctic Circle, possibly describing the icy sea as curdled. If they did arrive in the Arctic, then some of those earliest sailors might have never seen ice like the Arctic's ever before, once again contributing to the confusion and mystery surrounding what and where Thule was, because chroniclers were at a loss to describe it. Indeed, some suggested that it was an entire huge island far north of Great Britain, while others said it was further to the northwest, meaning it could have been what today is Iceland. To circle back then, might there yet be more reasons as to why those holes in the Arctic ice weren't noticed until recently, involving not the mechanism by which they were made, but how they were discovered? Sometimes aerial photography is necessary to find all sorts of things that were otherwise invisible. Down in Antarctica, for example, an underwater lake and river system was found only after looking at satellite photography that clearly showed depressions in the ice made by those water systems. In warmer climes, entire lost cities have also been discovered through aerial photography. For example, in recent years, we've seen the discovery of a lost city in Bolivia, deep in the Amazon rainforest. Without the ability to conduct surveys from the air, we may never have unearthed that city because the forest was so dense and overgrown that it would have been impossible to reach from the ground. So could methods like this one day uncover the truth about what ancient Thule was really like? Perhaps it had a much larger population than currently believed. Some researchers believe that it traded vital materials with the Roman Empire, so it must have had a developed society. But the mysterious people that lived there, perhaps 2,000 years ago, remain elusive and unknowable. Today, we have the strange appearance of holes in the Arctic ice, but also a choice of solid theories to explain them, most notably as the creation of local seals. But what do you think? Could there be something else afoot? Another possibility for this surprising display of geometry? And if we can hone in on just a couple of shapes on the landscape, then is it about time that we finally uncover the truth surrounding other Arctic mysteries, like the where, when, and who of ancient Thule? What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.